थैंक यू वेरी मच। श्री कृष्णा कुमार के चेयरमैन माइंड ट्रस्ट, मिस वीना वेणुगोपाल, श्रीमती कृष्णा कुमार पी श्रीलता, सहोदरी सहोदरन मारे नमस्कार। I am delighted to be with you on this occasion when you are celebrating 4th anniversary of Mobility in Dystrophy Trust, which has been working towards creating awareness about the physical condition called muscular dystrophy. I see this celebration on the theme of mobility as a creative way of highlighting the need to make aware of muscular dystrophy so that the people and our public sphere are encouraged to take a more supportive attitude towards those affected by this disease. Let me therefore begin by appreciating the efforts being made by Mind Trust to mobilize and empower people suffering from muscular dystrophy and spinal muscular atrophy. I am informed that the trust has been helping patients to voice their concerns about this condition since its formation in 2016. I am deeply impressed by the efforts made by the members of the trust to mobilize support for this just cause. The difficulties due to COVID-19 have not dampened the spirit of the members, which I can see here. It is said that taking small steps may look really small, but those steps add up over time and would propel one closer to the goal. I am told that this organization, just now the president of the trust mentioned how they started as a small WhatsApp group, and those affected by this condition, they started reaching out to each other through networking and the conduct of awareness events. They found that a lot of people were enduring the effects of these incurable problems. And very soon, the trust could enroll over 500 people who were either residing in Kerala or hailing from Kerala. Closer interaction fostered understanding among members, and here we are now celebrating the 4th anniversary of the trust with greater hope and greater confidence. In fact, it was some months ago that Shri Krishna Kumar, who is the vice chairman of the trust, had called on me. He had been seeking an appointment to meet me last year. I thought I would meet him in Kollam whenever I visited the district so that he could avoid traveling to Thiruvananthapuram. However, he could come to Raj Bhavan and we met. And this meeting proved, this is, I'm not saying formally, this proved meeting proved to be highly instructive for me and made me understanding the difficulties faced by people suffering from muscular dystrophy. He explained to me that from his travel experience, he had noticed that many of the public places in our state lack the amenities which are needed to create a fully disabled friendly atmosphere. The physical hardship caused by muscular dystrophy, which is technically known as Duchenne muscular dystrophy, are well known. However, studies about this disease took quite a long time to become known to the people. I understand that it was sometime in 1830 that descriptions of a boy with progressive motor paralysis was first reported by Dr. Charles Bell, a Scottish anatomist. It took another 34 years for English physician Dr. Edward Marion to describe the clinical and pathological findings in 8 affected boys from 3 families in his book Practical and Pathological Researches on the Various Forms of Paralysis. He was also the first to recognize the maternal inheritance of this disorder. It was in the late 70s that more studies and researches were conducted on this medical condition. Today, medical research says that though it is difficult to arrest the downhill progression of dystrophic process with current disease management measures, the recent rapid advances in gene therapy hold promise that the course of these diseases could eventually be mitigated. That creates hope for all of us. Societal and governmental support is essential for people affected by muscular dystrophy. I am sure that Government of Kerala understands the need for such support for the patients. Support has to be rendered in different ways, beginning with provision of information about DMD and patient support groups. I understand that support has to be provided according to the age groups to which patients belong. Support at pediatric and teenage levels are very important, since it would help to instill confidence during the growing age. Referral to the specialist team, advice about the right level of exercise, genetic advice for the family have to be part of this endeavor. However, most importantly, making our buildings and other infrastructure truly friendly to the needs of the persons with disabilities deserves top priority. The theme of today's celebration also points to mobility, which is a booster of one's confidence. If people have to be truly and freely mobile, there have to be adequate facilities to ensure their movement. I am happy that Mind is making efforts to help many of its members who are not financially independent or have little access to informed medical care and education. One can imagine the situation if they come from families struggling to make ends meet. Already this trust has conducted periodical awareness camps in Thiruvananthapuram, Ernakulam and Thrissur. The gesture of providing financial assistance, organizing training programs to help members overcome their financial dependence through education and skill development and the yoga and exercise training deserve applause. The positive attitude of the people associated with mine reminds me of the saying that there is no education like adversity. What has so far been done by this group of enterprising people is reminiscent of what Saint Francis of Assisi once advised: start by doing what is necessary, then do what is possible, and suddenly you will find doing the impossible. By volunteering to highlight the adversities before society, by identifying people who need support, and by connecting fellow members to doctors who specialize in the subject, Mind Trust has won half the battle against this adversity. By frequently advising members regarding the latest developments in the medical field and therapies available, you are building confidence in hundreds of people. I am sure that these efforts, which are done with utmost shraddha or devotion, will alleviate the suffering of patients and empower them with courage to face the situation with a smile. The best way to handle adversity is to face it with confidence. Let me conclude with the lines from an essay by Flight Lieutenant MP Anil Kumar, a Keralite better known as the Chairborn Warrior, whose fight against disability continues to inspire people even after his demise. During his time as one of the best pilots of Indian Air Force, in his 20s, he suffered an accident which rendered him paraplegic for over 25 years. But in those years, he inspired the world with his writings. By biting the pen and writing in impeccable language and calligraphy, this is what he wrote: to surmount even seemingly insuperable obstacles, one has to muster the remnant faculties and shun the thought of disability, and then canalize one's dormant energies purposefully and wholeheartedly. It is not just physical ability and average intelligence, but an insatiable appetite for success and an unflagging willpower that would texture the warp and woof of the fabric called human destiny. Greater the difficulty, sweeter the victory. I wish every member of the Mind Trust a sweet victory over adversity. Through confidence and devotion to the cause, May your efforts to alleviate the present difficulties succeed. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu, valre nanni, jai hind.